Howdy folks, it's New Tool Monday. Well, normally we do new tools on Thursdays. I tell you what, this Thursday we will do a new tool, but right now I'm going to do this one because this is a new tool. And it's really about measuring, because I don't care if you're automotive, woodworking, metalworking, machinist type work, or 3D printing, which I do quite a bit of these days, you need a set of digital calipers to get into 3D printing, where if you draw something up or you're going to measure something to draw it up, you need a set of calipers. Set of calipers just makes life so much easier. And these digital calipers and things that are out now are fantastic. I'm old school, sure, but when it comes to the digital calipers, you got to love them. Wow. So here's the new tool, but also have something for you guys that do 3D printing. You're always looking for, you know, if you're looking for a product to make, I found something else here. This is a woodworking bench, and there are different styles and kinds of these things, but they have these crazy little peg holes in them. And this bench here came from Harbor Freight. It's a Windsor woodworking bench from Harbor Freight. It's not expensive or anything, but it only comes with these two types of plugs for doing clamping. And if you're into 3D printing, just imagine all the custom plugs. I just drew this one up, so I'll show it to you a little bit there. Yeah, I just drew that one up as an example of where you could make a round shape instead of a square, and I put this plug on the end of it, about the same, you know, depth to size, whatever, and have it fit in the bench. And you could have round plugs to fit certain or clamp certain types of wood jobs in. You could also do a frame, like a 90 degree frame, a small one, 3D print it with, again, a plug. Because this bench only comes, like I said, with these two items for basically clamping up everything and anything on the bench. And that sort of falls short of a few things that we could, you know, we could use. And 3D printing those things would be a no-brainer, but you would need this tool right here. You knew I was going somewhere with this, didn't you? So you need this tool here. And that's where this was going, because, you know, digital calipers, they're great for just about everything anyways. And this one here is one of the latest, newest ones out that I know of that showed up. And I'm not affiliated, not sponsored, not paid to throw this thing around at you. So I will be providing a link in the description below, but I won't talk about the features. And I have another one here that's an older one. Costs about the same as this one. Doesn't have anywhere near the features. And it also was a bit of a headache when I got it. This one here, the very first thing that caught my interest was it uses a regular, I call this like a computer memory battery, the good old CR 2032 battery. You can get those things anywhere. They're cheap. There's plenty of them. I have a box full in my drawer because I work on stuff like, I don't know if you guys, yeah, you see it, laptops and stuff like that. Like I worked on that laptop this week and putting a new hard drive in it and installing some software and whatever. Also did some repairs on it and things. But anyways, the thing is, I had to keep these batteries around all the time for different projects. Well, this uses this battery. Also, if you buy the tool, you get the battery already in it, plus you get a spare battery. So you're in good shape right from the get-go. Comes in this real basic kind of box. A little confusing. I don't like the way they printed the box up, but it's 150 millimeter or 6 inches, which is, of course, the total scale. And that's pretty much standard for all of them these days. This one here, the next feature it had that caught my interest was this one will go to sleep. So after a few minutes, if you leave it laying on the bench or something, it'll shut itself down to save the battery. So you're not going to kill the battery, which my old one was eating batteries like crazy. My old one also had a special exotic battery, which I had to go on the internet to try to find it. You couldn't go to the local stores or anything to buy it. And when I did find it, I had to buy a bulk load of about 20 or 24 batteries or something. And every 3-4 times I would pull it out, it would be like, you know, it's getting really hard to read, and, you know, it's smaller digital. It's not quite as large a readout as this one here. So I ended up having to, you know, pitch the batteries all the time, and I was getting kind of tired of that. So this is, let's get close up so you guys can see this tool a little bit better. This is a good caliper. It's a nice one. So if you have a digital, an old one, you might want to upgrade to something a little bit better. It's a little late for Christmas presents, but maybe if you order it, maybe you can get it in before Christmas happens. I think we're a little tight on that schedule, unfortunately. But it has the on-off switch, of course, you can shut it off. And it's a very positive kind of feel to the switch as opposed to my, again, my old one. And the old one, like I said, was about the same cost. This is a much more improved product. The other thing that really was a kind of a quick thing with the feature on this, it's waterproof. And I'm not gonna go dump it in the ocean to see if it is waterproof. I don't wanna destroy it. It's a precision piece of instrument, kind of like a Fender Stratocaster, yeah, from Jimi Hendrix days. But anyways, it's a precision piece of equipment. And you saw in the opening video, we saw my old Muchitoyo analog caliper, and I've had that thing for about 45 years. I've looked after it to this day. It has served me well, but I really love the digital. They're so easy and nice to work with when you just have the numbers come up here. And it's so easy to switch between inches and millimeters, so you can get whichever dimension you want to work in. But first off, we got the on-off. Then we have the zero. The zero is a good thing to have because over time, let's open this up a little bit and I'll just sort of wipe this with my fingers, which is probably a big no-no. Somebody's gonna type something in about that, probably about human oil heating, stainless steel. There you go, 000. Perfect, so it doesn't need to be zeroed out or anything, but you can go ahead and measure. And like if I was gonna make these plugs in 3D print, that would be one of my first things I guess I'd be looking for, is to see what size the old plugs were. Looks like about 15.6, 0.7. I would go actually 15.8 on the plug, maybe. A little tight, yeah, maybe 7.7, 15.7 millimeter to make these plugs up on my 3D printer. I'd also have to check, of course, the depth. And to check the depth, you could even, use this, or you could get real fancy, use the bottom side of this and drive this thing back here to where it hits the top like that, and then take a reading and say, okay, it's 18.27 whatever millimeter. Yeah, it's gonna come up kind of some weird dimensions, and a lot of times I'll just round off and take it down a little bit so that things fit really well, because this is a precision piece of equipment and it works really well. Price-wise, I think it's competitive because of its features. It also has a really nice lock here that it just feels really good when you open or close this thing. It slides really smooth. So we like that. Also has a little lock screw here. And on the top here is the slot for the battery. Now the back side, I've got some scales here. And unless you raced Norton motorcycles in the 80s like I did, some of the scale stuff's not gonna be much good to you. But we've got conversion chart, which includes Whitworth. Now that's like a British motorcycle, well, British nut and bolt size thing from good old England. That was another measurement that we, probably around the US, they probably never even, probably never heard of it, but I'm sure hopefully somebody in the comments will talk about Whitworth sizes. I guess the fellow's name was Whitworth, and he came up with his own scale of inches and whatever at the time for scaling stuff out. But there's also a complete conversion chart back here. So there's also the metric and some of the other sizes that are right on the back side of this. Okay, focus. Yeah, pray for me, guys. Focus. I'll probably, we'll see if we can get the camera to work with me on that. Probably not, but you never know. Anyways, stainless steel construction and has a zinc coating, so hopefully it should last. It should last 40 years like my old one did. But overall, like I said, the features, the battery, what have you, the more you know about these calipers and you get into them, the more you probably would like this one. The waterproof thing, I'm not that worried about getting it wet, but it has happened, mostly cutting oil or something spilled or something weird, or if you're drinking a coffee while working on things, you don't have to worry, you're not gonna tear this machine up. But also, because it's waterproof, it's gonna help keep dust and dirt and crap out of there. So this thing, again, it'll just add to its life expectancy. So, awesome tool this week, and I gotta show it to you. Like I said, I'm gonna provide a link in the description below, as I said, and you can go take a look, go check them out. Excellent product, comes with a nice instruction manual. The manual is in a number of different languages. It's in English, but it's also in Italian, Spanish, French, and I think German, yeah. So it sort of covers all the major common languages around the world. If you're in Russia right now, sorry, you're out of luck. Yeah, it didn't happen. Anyways, and it also comes with this nice little cloth that helped to, keep it nice and shiny and clean, because it's a really good tool. This is the sort of thing I keep around my 3D printer, but I also keep the old analog in my toolbox, because you run up on stuff, whether you're a machinist working on cars, trucks, planes, rocket ships, whatever it is. And also, if you're using a 3D printer, this is like almost like the next tool you need. After you get a 3D printer, you sort of need to get into one of these if you're gonna do any drawing up or design. And like I said, this is just an idea, but I thought I'd throw this out to you guys. You could make these things and, I don't know, make four per, you know, shipment for eBay or something and sell them, just make custom, you know, sizes or whatever. Because this bench, like I said, just doesn't come with much of anything for plugs. And so something like this will get you going. So there's my tool for Monday. This is the hack job Monday. So that's why I'm showing you this for the 3D, is it's sort of like the Monday hack thing. Anyway, the other thing we're gonna be doing is Thursday, of course, another new tool coming in that's here right now. And Thursday we'll be discussing another new tool. But the caliper this week, the caliper this week is the big item, and it is really sweet. This is something you just probably carry this baby around for life, you know, because it'll always get you out of trouble. Okay. Wow, so this was sent over just to have a look at it, but like I said, there's no affiliate, no sponsor, nothing like that. So it's just something that I wanted to cover this week because I got very excited. The features was what caught my interest, and I said, yeah, I need a good set of calipers for working around here and the 3D printer. So I'm sharing it with you guys on our, what we'll call our Hacker Monday or whatever. This film won't be released until Tuesday, unfortunately. Christmas is really bogging things down, so we're trying to get the films out as fast as I can, fellas. And Thursday, new tool. Wow, we've got so many new tools. I might do a tool every other day or something until Christmas is. We are backed up. Hey, thank you for watching Coffee and Tools and looking in on us this week. And please like, share, subscribe, and over and out.